Good morning everyone, I am Gaurav Gupta, Azure Mathematics teacher. Today we will discuss how to represent a square root number on a number line. In the first lecture we already discussed how to represent a number, decimal point number on a number line. It is very easy to locate, but the question arises here, how we can locate a number which is in terms of square root of a number. Then what's the procedure that we have to follow to represent it? So in this lecture you will be understand how we locate a number. So square root of a number, I am going to take two cases. First case is whenever we have to represent a square root of a number, we have two cases. As x is a positive integer, it means positive 1, positive 2 and so on. And second case is whenever x is a decimal point number. The main focus is how to represent x is a decimal point number, because x, when x is a square root number, this is your first exercise, it's very easy to represent. But the main question arises, how we can represent a square root in terms of decimal point number. This is the question number 4 of your exercise 1.5. Represent square root of 9.3. 9.3 is basically your decimal point number on the number lines. So how we can represent this on a number line? So firstly, you have to clear in your mind, we have to represent a form which is in terms of a square root, and how we get a number in terms of a square root. So in this we have to use a concept which is called a Pythagoras theorem. Everyone will know about what is Pythagoras. Pythagoras theorem, what it says? It is basically applied on your right angle triangle. And you know what is right angle triangle? Right angle triangle is that triangle in which one angle is your 90 degree and it has three sides. One side is called base, second one is called perpendicular or height, and third side is called hypotenuse. And hypotenuse is the longest side of the right angle triangle. And all the sides are connected by a relation which is called Pythagoras theorem, which it said, square of sum, it means, again I repeat, sum of square of two sides is equal to square of the third side, is called the Pythagoras theorem. Again I repeat, sum of square of the two sides, if we square two sides and we have to take its sum, then the sum is equal to square of the third side. So I am going to represent a right angle triangle, because the whole concept is totally dependent on the this concept. So this one is your right angle triangle. So this angle is your 90 degree, so which is also called a right angle triangle. And this side is called base, which is represented by capital B. This is your hypotenuse, which is represented by capital H. And this one is your perpendicular, represented by P. P, B and H are connected by a relation which is called a Pythagoras theorem. I am using Pythagoras theorem. What it say? It say square of perpendicular plus square of base is equal to square of hypotenuse. So if you want to calculate the hypotenuse, then how we calculate the hypotenuse? By taking a square root. So if you calculate, if you want to calculate h, then what will be its value? P square plus b square. So this term gives a terms or a number in terms of a square root. So we have to use this concept to represent either of these two numbers. How we can do? Please make a note first. Firstly, you have to look your number, which is your square root of 5. It means we have to come, we have to take 5 in square root. Then we have to choose the values of P and B. So this is based on our imagination, but we have to take the values of पी एंड बी। सपोज आई एम टेकिंग दैट पी इज इक्वल टू 1 एंड बी इज इक्वल टू 2, देन व्हाट विल बी द रिजल्ट ऑफ एच? एच इज योर टी स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर विच इज इक्वल टू 1 स्क्वेयर प्लस 2 स्क्वेयर विच इज इक्वल टू 1 प्लस 4 विच इज इक्वल टू स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ 5। इट मीन्स वी गेट स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ 5। इट मीन्स इफ वी हैव टू रिप्रेजेंट अ स्क्वेयर रूट नंबर 5, वी हैव टू मेक अ ट्रायंगल ऑफ राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल, बिकॉज इन दिस वी गेट अ साइड ऑफ स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ 5। सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इन दिस, फर्स्टली यू हैव टू ड्रॉ अ नंबर लाइन। प्लीज मेक अ स्टेप, फर्स्टली वी हैव टू ड्रॉ, प्लीज मेक अ नोट फर्स्ट, देन आई विल राइट हियर। सो लेट्स वी प्रोसीड हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट। फर्स्टली वी हैव टू मेक ए राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल, देन हाउ वी कैन मेक, फर्स्टली वी हैव टू ड्रॉ ए नंबर लाइन एक्सिस एंड रिप्रेजेंट ए नंबर लाइन एक्सिस। यू कैन टेक 0 फ्रॉम एनी एंड राइट द नंबर्स 1, 2, 3 एंड सो। सो दिस नंबर इज 1, दिस इज 2 एंड सो ऑन। नाउ हियर सेम, दिस वन इज -1 एंड दिस विल बी। नाउ वी हैव टू टेक, दिस इज योर, इफ आई एम टेकिंग अ यूनिट इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेंटीमीटर, देन यू कैन इमेजिन दिस इज योर 1 सेंटीमीटर, दिस इज 2 सेंटीमीटर एंड सो ऑन। इफ यू टेक द यूनिट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ मीटर, देन यू कैन इमेजिन दिस इज योर 1 मीटर, दिस इज योर 2 मीटर एंड सो ऑन, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द यूनिट। बट इन दिस वी हैव टू लोकेट द नंबर, द यूनिट इज नॉट स्पेसिफाइड, सो वी हैव टू टेक इट एज ए 1। इफ वी कंबाइन दिस, सो वी कैन मेक इट एज ए 2। नाउ व्हाट्स वी हैव टू टेक, वी हैव टू टेक बेस इज इक्वल टू 2, बेस इज योर हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन। इट मीन्स वी हैव टू टेक अ वैल्यूज ऑफ 2 इन बेस। बेस मीन्स दिस, दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ 1 एंड इफ वी एड 1 वी गेट अ बेस, दिस इज योर कंप्लीट बेस, दिस इज योर बेस। I represented it by A and it is represented by B. So it becomes our base. Base is equal to 2. So this is base which is equal to 2. Now we have to represent a perpendicular, and we know how we represent a perpendicular, by making an angle of 90 degree. So I am making an angle of 90 degree. If you want to write the construction step, so you can write easily. First, you have to take a number line and locate the number. Second step, now take two blocks as equal to your base. Now third step, make an angle at 90 degree at point B. Now I am drawing an angle of 90 degree at point B. So this one is your 90 degree. And we have to take P is equal to 1. It means this is the length of 1 unit. So open the compass and open the compass and make a 1 unit length from this point say to this point and cut it on this point. I suppose I am given this name as C. So this side is equal to 1. This side is equal to 1. Same as 1, or this is 1. So now we have to make the join with base to height. We get a side of which is called hypotenuse. Now join this. We join this. What we will got? We got h. And what is h? H is your square root of 5. It means we got the values of square root of 5. It means this length is 2, this one and this one is root 5, and we have to represent it on a number line. Number line is your this line. So now again open the compass and one point put it here and second point here. Now open the compass of length AC and make a arc. Now I am drawing an arc. This. It cut at point D. it cut point D on the number line axis. And what is actually this length is? This is, this point is A and this point is D. This is your root 2 and this is the representation of square root 2 on a number lines. I hope you understand this video. So please make a note first, then I am giving some more example of such type. Now our next question is, represent square root of 3 on a number line. We have to do all the steps. See, so firstly we have to assume the values of perpendicular and base so that we get a values of square root 3. Is it possible any values of P and B we get a value of 3? If I take P and B is equal to 1 and 1, then we get 1 square is 1 plus 1 square is 1, we get square root of 2. If I will take 2 as a perpendicular and 1 as a base, then I will get 1 square is 1 and 2 square is 4. 4 plus 1 y is equal to 5. It means we can obtain square root 3. Either we can easily obtain by square root of 2 or square root of 5, but we can't find square root of 3. So how we will find such type of number? In this we have to make two right angle triangles. How is it possible? Because firstly I will take, let P is equal to 1 and B is 1. I am taking P is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Then what I will got? H is equal to square root of P square plus main B square, which is equal to 1 square plus main 1 square, which is equal to root 2, but not the values of root 3. Now I am going to represent, I am going to take another right angle triangle. Why it is? Because that triangle will give us the term square root of 3. Now I am taking second case. First, draw first triangle. Now draw second triangle. Now we have to draw second triangle. Then what the values of P and B? Now in this case you have to take one value is square root of 2 as a base so that we can get the square root of 3 easily. Please make a look. Let P is 1 and B is square root of 2. Now I'm taking perpendicular as a 1 and base as a square root of 2. Then what will be its value of H? H again. Formula of H is P square plus B square. What's the value of P is 1, it means we get 1 square. What's the value of B? B is square root of 2. We take square root of 2. Then what will be the results? Square of 1 is 1. And you know, if we do square of a square root number, then square root will be cancelled out and we get the only the number. Then the what's the number? Is 2. And 2 plus 1, which is equal to root 3. And this is the number which we have to represent. It means the question is solved. But in this case, we have to take two right angle triangle. And how we can make on a number line two right angle triangle? So firstly, first step we use is draw a number line. I am drawing a number line. This is our number line. I am representing it as 0, 1, 2, and so on. This one is minus 1. In first case, what we have to take? Perpendicular is equal to 1 and base is equal to 1. It means we have to take base 1. I am taking this side A and B. This is our base. This is base is equal to 1. And now we have to take perpendicular, and for that perpendicular we have to draw a right angle triangle. So draw a right angle triangle at B. This is a right angle triangle and we have to take the length of the perpendicular is 1 unit. So open the compass of length AB and draw the arc at point P. Again I repeat, open the compass of length AB and at point B draw an arc which cut this axis at point C. So this length is also 1. Now join points A and C. I am joining the points AC. This is your base, this one your perpendicular, and this is your hypotenuse. And we already get what's the hypotenuse is? Square root of 2. It means we get 2. This is your H. So we draw our first right angle triangle. Now we have to draw our second right angle. And the second right angle has base is equal to root 2. And where it is root 2? Root 2 is here. It means this hypotenuse will act as a base of the second right angle triangle. So in this, keep in mind, this is our base. That's why I am removing H here, because this side act as a base of the second right angle triangle. It means we have to take it as AC as a base and make a right angle head on C. It's very difficult to draw, because at point C we have to draw a right angle triangle. So either you can use a compass or you can use a D and make an angle of 90 degree at point C. So I am drawing, if I extend this, so we can easily make a right angle angle at point this. So I again make here is a right angle triangle. So first what I did, I extend this and make angle of 90 degree at point C. Now we get base is square root 2. Okay. Now we have to take perpendicular is equal to 1. Now same length of AB, make an arc of length AB which cut this axis at point D. I am giving name this as D. Now join this. Join this. So this length becomes, because this is your base, this is your perpendicular, and this is your hypotenuse, and hypotenuse in this case is root 3. So this length is root 3. So we have to represent it. Now open the compass and take it one point at point A and second point on D and draw an arc. How we can draw an arc? Open the compass, putting at one point at point A and second point on D and make an arc. So if I make an arc, again I repeat, open the compass and put one point at point A and second point on D and make an arc. Make an arc by using compass. So it is just like here. This point is I denoted by E. Then what's the length of square root 5 from A point to E? This is your A point and this is your E point and this is your square root of 5. Please make a note first. I hope you understand this concept. Now we are going to represent our second case. Represent a square root of x, but here today. Now we have to take x as a decimal point integer. In the first case we are taking x as a positive integer, but in this case we are going to take x as a decimal point number. Then what we have to do? So because this concept is totally based to evaluate the or to represent the question number 4 from exercise 1.5. So before to start the question, we have to understand its base, why we are doing such step to represent the square root of a decimal point number. So firstly we discuss the concept, then we easily represent this square root of decimal point number. First step is your step 1. First we have to draw a line of x unit First, we have to draw a line of x unit. For example, we have to represent 9.3. So this is your x. Here x is, you can take here x is 9.3. So you have to draw a line of 9.3 centimeter. So now I am represent or drawing a line AB of 9.3 centimeter. If I am taking units in centimeter length, first we have to draw a length of 9.3 centimeter. But in this case, we have to calculate generalized expression. So in this, I have taking a length of x unit. So the length of AB is x. This is our question. What we have to do in both the steps? This is the generalized case, and this is the specialized case for your question number 4. Now extend that line 1 centimeter along any one direction. Suppose I am taking right side. Increase. I am doing increase, extend 1 centimeter. Suppose this is 1 centimeter. I am taking this as a C. So the length of BC is 1. So please draw a 1 centimeter, extend the line. So I am extend the line here 1 centimeter. So this is your 1 centimeter. And again repeat, firstly you have to represent or whatever you want to represent, draw a line on the number line. You can say that simply draw a line and extend 1 centimeter along in any direction. I am going to take it in right hand direction. So I extend this in right side along of a length of 1 centimeter and gives a name of C. So this length is your 1. This is your 1. Then it becomes, what it becomes? It becomes x plus 1. AC becomes x plus 1. In this case, what AC becomes? AC is 9.3 plus 1, which is equal to 10.3 centimeter. Now make it half. This is our step 1. Step 2. Make half of AC. What is AC is here? X plus 1, and we have to take half. How we do half? If I have 10, then what will be that? It's half, 10 by 2, which is equal to 5. It means we have to divide by 2 and we get the half. And here this 10.3 divided by 2, which is equal to 5.15 centimeter. This is your AC. And you get this done by using a bisector method. By using bisector method, as we already discussed in class 8. What we have to do? We have to do open the compass of half, greater than half of the length. Half of the length is here 5.15. You have to open the compass of greater than length 5.15. Suppose you open the compass of 7 cm and make an arc from here and here. Then place the compass at here, point this, and at this point this, which cut the axis. You got a point, that point. This is called the bisector of the line AC. I given a name D. So in this, I bisect this. So what will I got? This point is D. And Now open the compass of length 5.13, or you can say that open the compass and put it 1 point at point D, and open the length A and make a semi circle. Now you have to draw a semi circle here. How we can draw? Open the compass, put one point is here and second point is at point D, and here draw an arc which is your semicircle. Again I repeat, because we get half is equal to 5.13, so open the compass of 5.13 and put at point D and draw an arc which is your semicircle. So in this I am going to same process here. Then what will be the length according to this? I am writing here, what is the length of AD is? What is AD? AD is, because what is AC divided by 2? I divided by 2. Then if we divide AC by 2, we get AD. So the length of AD is 5.15. Again I repeat, firstly I have a length of 9.3 cm and I extend it 1 cm, then the overall length becomes 9.3 + 1 = 10.3. Now I make it half at point D, so D means this length AD and DC are equal. AD and DC are equal, AD and DC are equal, and what are the length? Half of the AC, half of the AC. So 10.3 divided by 2, we get 5.15. Now what we have to do, in I'm writing same process as here, we get AD is equal to DC, which is equal to half, and in this case what's the half is x plus 1 divided by 2. So we get x plus 1 divided by 2. Now draw an angle of 90 degree at point B. Now draw an angle of 90 degree at point B. So I'm drawing right angle at point B. Draw an angle of 90 degree at point B, which cut the semicircle at point E. Again, please make a note here, I am drawing an angle of 90 degree. So you have to draw an angle of 90 degree, which cut the semicircle at point E. Now join this. A to D. Now join. Now join D and E. And please make a note first, then we will do our next step. Please make a note. I hope you are understanding this concept. So our question is, what we have to represent? Square root of 9.3, and if this length EB, please make a dark, this length EB, length of EB is equal to square root of 9.3, which is your final answer. So we represented length of EB, which is equal to 9.3, which is our answer. And the question arises, is this really a length of 9.3 cm? We have to check by using this process. I again repeat the whole concept. First we have to draw a length of AB of the desired length. Here is 9.3, so I am drawing the length of AB is 9.3. Then extend it along any one direction. I am taking direction towards right hand side. The length becomes 1 cm. The whole length becomes 9.3 plus 1, which is equal to 10.3 cm. Now this length AC is 10.3 and we have to take half. And if we take half, half means we have to divide by 2. If we divide 10.3 divided by 2, we get 5.15. So this is the half at point D, and which we can do by using bisector method. We have to open the compass greater than length of 5.15. We have to choose the length of 7 cm and make and draw an arc at point from point A as well as C, which cut here and at this point. Now if you join this length, we get a point D, and D is the bisector of the length AC. So this length and this length is equal to same. So this is your AD and this is your CDC. DC and AD, which is this half of AC. Half of AC is 10.3 by 2, 1.15. So now at point D, draw a semicircle of length of AD. Our next step is draw an angle of 90 degree at point B, which cut the semicircle at point E. Now join this, we get a length of EB. The length of EB is equal to 9.3 cm, which is truth. How is it truth? We have to discuss the concept that we are going to discussing here. So please make a note first, then we can understand how it is 9.3. Please make a note first. Now we have to understand what's the concept behind this question that we already did. As for your examination purpose, we already did the explanation. But how the concept will work and we get the length EB is equal to 9.3. Is it really or not? We have to discuss the concept here. We have to follow the all the steps. So in this case, we have to join DE. If we join this, now please make a look. What is DE? D is nothing, basically a radius of the circle. This is your radius of the circle. DE is what? Radius of the circle. And please make a note here, AD. Because D is center of the circle, D is center of the circle. So DA or AD also a radius, CD also a radius. Because if we draw a circle and this is a point, your D, so length A and D also a radius, and this D and C is also a radius. So D is radius of the circle, also AD and DC are also the radius of the circle. So please make a note here, and we get already AD and DC, which is equal to x plus 1 by 2, and AD, DC, DE all are equal because all are the radius. So I can put also here DE. So we get an equation here. Now please make a look, because we are drawing here 90 degree angle. So DBE, what is? It is a right angle triangle. Triangle DBE is a right angle triangle. is a right angle triangle, and you have to study about this. Again apply perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. In this we have to calculate the perpendicular, we have to calculate the base, and we have to calculate the hypotenuse. I already discussed in this EB. EB is what? The of the desired length. It means this EB must be your square root. So it means we have to calculate EB. What we have to find out? We have to find out EB. This is our desired result. This is our desired result. And what we have to find out? DP and DE. DE we already know. DE is equal to x plus 1 divided by 2. Now we have to calculate DB. How we calculate DB? As we can write AD plus DB is equal to, I can write AB. Because if I AD plus DB, which is equal to AB. And what is AB? What is AB we already takes? This is your x. This is your x and this is your plus 1. So AB is what? X. So I can take AB is x. And what's the value of? We have to calculate DB. So if we want to calculate DB, put AB on the right hand side. But we will put AD. Now put the values of AD, which is equal to x plus 1 by 2. X plus 1 divided by 2. Divide by 1, take it as 2 as a common. If we take 2 as common, we get 2x. And here negative sign outside of the bracket, the sign will be changed. Then what we will got? We got minus x minus 1. 2x minus x, which is equal to x minus 1 by 2. It means we got DB. Is equal to x minus 1 by 2. Now what's our answer is? We have to find out EB. We have to find out EB. Now apply Pythagoras theorem. Apply Pythagoras theorem. What is? P square plus me B square is equal to h square. What is P? Perpendicular is EB. So we can write EB square plus what is base? Base is your DB. DB square. What is h? DE. DE square. Now substitute all the values. But we have to calculate EB. So put it on the left hand side and take DB on the right hand side. EB whole square is equal to DE whole square minus DB whole square. Now we have to solve this. So I have to rub this portion. So please make a note first. So now I am solving here. EB square is equal to DE. And what's the values of DE? DE is equal to x plus 1 by 2. X plus 1 divided by 2 whole square minus DB. And what's the values of DB is? X minus 1 by 2. X minus 1 by 2. Now solve this. We can write as x plus 1 whole square divided by square of 2 is 4. Again, x minus 1. Let's make a note first. So solve this. It becomes x minus 1 whole square. 2 square is 4. Now take 4 as an LCM. What we will got? X plus 1 whole square minus x minus 1 whole square. If we solve this, a plus b whole square, apply this, a square plus b square plus में 2ab 2x minus a square plus में b square minus 2ab divide by 4. Now again solve this. x square plus में 1 plus में 2x. Here negative sign is outside of the bracket, so change the sign of the all the terms. Minus x square minus 1 plus में 2x divide by 4. Now x square will be cancelled out with the x square. Minus 1 will be cancelled out with 1. But we will got 2x plus 2x, which is equal to 4x by 4. So we get x. X is what? We get EB whole square is equal to x. So EB, if we take square root, we get, and in the previous case, we got 9.3. So that's why I am right, the length of EB is 9.3. So this is the reason why do we follow the all the steps to represent a decimal point number in square root. This is the concept that we have to understand why we are doing. Because if you don't know why we are doing, just to remember, useless to learn, then your concept will be destroyed. So you have to clear your all the concept. Then you have to do for your examination point of view. So in for your examination point of view, we already did. It will be completing your half and page. But the whole concept is this, why we are follow these steps. I hope you like my video. If you like my video, so don't forget to subscribe my channel, Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. Then I will make another video that will help you to strong the your concept as well as to crack your competitive exams. So don't forget to subscribe and share to your friends also, so that all one can find out or can obtain the benefits of such type of video. So see you again to take with our next video. Thank you for watching from start to end.